So let's talk about the Reynolds number. Reynolds number typically is seen as RE. What this is a dimensionless group. It's kind of defined for fluid flowing in a pipe. And we write that as the density of that fluid times the velocity of the fluid times the diameter of the pipe over the viscosity of the fluid. All right. And the nice thing about the Reynolds number is it kind of follows this pattern that if it's less than 2100, we say that the flow is laminar. It follows nice streamlines, nice being fairly straight. Whereas if the Reynolds number is greater than 2100, we consider it to be turbulent. Turbulent is kind of defined as a flow that is heavily agitated. So we might just see it all over the place, maybe get some eddies. It's kind of what you might see, very fast stream of water. So just to do an exercise in unit conversion and see what a dimensionless group is. Let's go ahead and make up some values and figure out what the fluid flow for water would be given certain properties. So I'm totally making these up, but the density of water is going to be, in this case, 1 gram per centimeter cubed. Let's say that the velocity is, I don't know, 100 centimeters per second, so moving fairly fast. The diameter of the pipe that we're going to look at, let's go ahead and say that it is a meter wide, so fairly large. And then the viscosity of water is about a centipoise. And a centipoise is equivalent to 1 times 10 to the minus 3 kilogram per meter second. All right, so given these values, go ahead and try to calculate what the Reynolds number would be for this fluid. Okay, I'm going to move this up. Now, there's two ways to approach this. One is we could make sure that all the units we're using up front match, and then we could just plug in numbers, or we could set up one single dimensionless equation for the Reynolds number and go from there. I kind of prefer going the first route. It just makes it easier since we know that these are the only variables that we're going to use. So if we start with grams and centimeters cubed, we got to make sure everything else is in those terms. We have centimeters per second here, and we have meters, so we need to convert this to 100 centimeters. And then the last is the centipoise. If we have 1 times 10 to the minus 3 kilograms per meter second, we can convert to grams using that conversion factor, and we can convert to centimeters using that conversion factor. So this is going to give us 1 times 10 to the minus 2 grams per centimeter second. So now all of these units are in the same, and we can go ahead and start to estimate our Reynolds number. Okay, so if we plug in these values, again, the Reynolds number is equal to the density times the velocity times the diameter over the viscosity. Then we'll see that 1 gram per centimeter cubed times our velocity of 100 centimeters per second times our diameter of 100 centimeters. This is going to be divided by 1 times 10 to the minus 2 grams, and then centimeters second goes on top. So if we were to see what the units of the remaining value is going to have, grams on top cancels with grams on bottom. The centimeters times centimeters times centimeters gets canceled by the centimeter cubed, and then the seconds get canceled. So we're left with a unitless number, which in this case is going to be 100 times 100 times 100, or 1 times 10 to the sixth. So in this case, we're going to say that Reynolds number is greater than 2100. It's actually about, or it is, 1 million in this case, so it's highly turbulent, which you would expect with a velocity of 100 centimeters per second in a very large tube for water. Hopefully, this gave you some practice at just unit conversions, and you will see Reynolds number in the future, and a lot of other dimensionless groups.